Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the topic Bayes' theorem. Let E1, E2 and so on, En be the n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Mutually exclusive means no two or more events can occur simultaneously. That is, the type of events are called mutually exclusive events. So, exhaustive events means all possible events in a trial are called exhaustive events. Suppose we are tossing a coin. What are the possible events happening of head and tail? Only two possible events. That are the two exhaustive events. So, all possible events in a trial is called exhaustive events. Mutually exclusive events means no two or more events can happen simultaneously is called mutually exclusive events. So E1, E2 and so on En are mutually exclusive and exhaustive events such that P of Ei is greater than 0 for all I. That is for all I. So probability of each event is always greater than 0 in a sample space S, and A is any other event in S. Let A is any other event in S intersecting with every Ei such that P of A greater than 0. P of Ei given A is equal to P of Ei into P of A given Ei by P of E1 into P of A given E1 plus P of E2 into P of A given E2 plus and so on P of En plus P of A given En. So P of Ei given A, that means probability of happening of Ei after the happening of A. So this is P of Ei given B. P of Ei given A means probability of happening of Ei after the happening of A, that is denoted by P of Ei given A. So this is the Bayes' theorem. Just see one problem. If the chance that a doctor will diagnose a disease correctly is 60%. So chance means probability. The probability that doctor will diagnose a disease correctly is 60%. The chance that a patient will die by his treatment after the correct diagnosis is 40%. So if the doctor treat the patient correctly but the patient is died, the percentage, the probability is 40%. The chance of death by wrong diagnosis is 70%. The probability of death by wrong diagnosis is 70%. A patient of a doctor who had a disease, what is the chance that his disease was diagnosed correctly? A patient is dead, but he is treated with the correct process by the doctor. So here probability that doctor will diagnose the disease correctly is 60%. Here there are two events. One is diagnosis of the disease and death of a patient. Here two events are there. Let A be the event that the patient is dead. Patient dead is denoted by the event A. And let E be the event that the disease is correctly diagnosed by the doctor. E be the event that disease is correctly diagnosed by the doctor. So P of E is equal to probability of diagnosing the disease correctly. P of E is equal to probability of diagnosing the disease correctly. That is given in the problem 60%. So 60% is equal to 60 by 100. That is 0.6. So E bar be the event that disease is wrongly diagnosed by the doctor. That is P of E bar is equal to 1 minus P of E. That is 1 minus 0.6. That is 0.4. P of E given A. A denotes the patient dead and E denotes correctly diagnosed. Here patient dead by the correctly diagnosation of the doctor, that is 40%, that is given in the problem 40%. So that is 40 by 100, that is 40 by 100, 40% 40 by 100, that is 0.4. So next, P of E bar given A, patient dead but it is wrongly diagnosed by the doctor. Probability of the patient dead after the wrongly diagnosation, that is 70%, 70 by 100, that is 0.7. So now apply Bayes' theorem. P of A given E is equal to P of E into P of E given A by P of E into P of E given A plus P of E bar into P of E bar given A. So P of E is 0.6, P of E given A is 0.4, 0.6 into 0.4 plus 0.4 into 0.7. If you simplify this, we can get 6 by 13. Let's see another problem. A bag A contains 2 white balls and 3 red balls. Bag B contains 4 white balls and 5 red balls. One ball is drawn at random from one of the bags and it is found to be red. Find the probability that red ball is drawn from the bag B. Here 2 events. Selection of a bag is one event and drawing a red ball is another event. So here 2 events. Let A and B are denotes the events of selecting bag A and bag B respectively. If you select the bag A, so it is denoted by an event capital A. If you select the bag B, it is denoted by an event capital B. So there are 2 events, selection of bag A and selection of bag B. Suppose we are tossing a coin, there is 2 events, probability of getting head and probability of getting tail, that is 1/2 and 1/2. So here also 2 events, probability of selecting a bag A and probability of selecting bag B. So that is P of A is equal to 1/2 and P of B is equal to 1/2. Suppose we are throwing a die. Die has a 6 face. So each face has probability of 1/6. So probability of getting 1 on a die is 1/6. Probability of getting 2 on a die is 1/6. All numbers have equal probability. So 6 faces 1/6. Here two events, A and B. A and B have equal probability. So P of A is equal to 1/2 and P of B is equal to 1/2. Let R denotes the event of drawing a red ball. Red ball, drawing a red ball is denoted by capital R. If bag A is selected, the probability of drawing a red ball from A. So in a bag A, how many balls are there? Two white balls and 3 red balls. 2 plus 3, 5. Total number of balls in bag A are 5. How many red balls are there? 3. So 3/5. Probability of drawing a red ball from bag A is 3/5. So bag B is selected, the probability of drawing a red ball from bag B. So bag B contains 4 white balls and 5 red balls. 4 plus 5, total number of balls are 9, red balls are 5. So 5/9. So P of R given B is equal to 5/9. Probability of selecting a red ball from bag B. So we have to calculate P of B given R. Here we have to apply Bayes' theorem. P of B given R is equal to P of B into P of R given B by P of A into P of R given A plus P of B into P of R given B. P of B value is 1/2. P of R given B value is 5/9. So P of A value is 1/2. P of R given A value is 3/5. P of B value is 1/2. P of R given B value is 5/9. If we simplify, 5/18 and 3/10, 5/18. So if you take the LCM, 18 and 10, the LCM is 90. So take the LCM. So value is 27 plus 25. So that is 52. 18 5 is 90. So 25/52. So this is the problem. Let's see another problem. In a certain college, 25% of boys and 10% of the girls are studying mathematics. So 25% of boys and 10% of the girls are studying mathematics. The girls constitute say 60% of the students. Out of 100 students, there are 60 students are girls. That means 60% of the students are girl students. If a student is selected at random and is found to be studying the mathematics, find the probability that student is a girl. So here P of G, probability of girl students that is given in the problem 60%, that is 60 by 100, that is 0.6. Probability of boy P of B is equal to 1 minus P of G, that is 1 minus 0.6, that is 0.4. The probability that mathematics is studied given that a student is a boy. Boy student is studying the mathematics, that is given 25%, that is 25 by 100, that is 1 by 4. Probability that mathematics is studied and given that the student is a girl student, that is also given 10% of our girls, so that is 10 by 100, that is 1 by 10. The probability of mathematics student is a girl, so that is P of G given M is equal to P of G into P of M given G by P of G into P of M given G plus P of B into P of M given B. So P of G, that is 0.6, P of M given G, that is M given G, that is 1 by 10, P of G, that is 0.6, P of M given G is 1 by 10, P of B value is 0.4, P of M given B value is 1 by 4. If you simplify 0.06 by 0.06, so 0.4 can be written as 4 by 10, 10 into 4, that is 40, so 4 by 40, so 4 ones are 4 tens are, so 1 by 10, 1 by 10 can be written as 0.1, so 0.06 by 0.06 plus 1, so that is 0.06 by 0.16. If you divide